Simon Kof Samach, Ezo Maim Kshirim Ezo Psum, and it's in a vote test of Sif and Maim Shinishtan and Marehan. Water that their appearance has been changed. Bin Machas Asman and Machas Dover Shinaf on the Sochan, whether they themselves changed Conger, whether something fell into them, Bin Machas Makum, or the place where they are changed Psum. They're possible, it needs to be water that looks like water. Also, b'mayim melachi did melacha with the water. Osher shorav b'am pito, he soaked his bread in the water. Filu niskaven lishus b'kuzev nafal l'shin. Even though he didn't have kavana to do melacha with this water, he had kavana to do it with a different water, but it fell in this clay psulim. It's possible because it did melacha with it. V'mtzinen yain b'mayim psulim. If he used the water to cool off wine, that would be considered a melacha, and that would be possible. If he used it to wash dishes, it would be possible, or vegetables, or wash anything. Remember, if he used it just to wash off clean kalim, or new kalim, that there was no need to wash off at all, then it would be kosher, because it's not considered a malacha. The baker used it to soak the loaves of bread in it while he was baking, that would be possible. So, Avlim Taval Yadav B'mayim B'tach Pnei Gluskin. If he had his hands were clean, he stuck his hands in the water to get them wet to then rub that water on the dough. Or Shechafin Mehem B'chafnav, or he used it to take a handful of water out from there to pour on something else. Hamayim Anishonim Lenasa B'malacha. The rest of the water is not considered to have done malacha. Lefichach Kshirim Lenishtanu Mayran. That's considered kosher as long as they didn't change their appearance. But in Mayim Shenachta Mendiach Yadav Behem Min Ambatzei Kadavik B'yadav. The same thing is true if there's water that the Nachtam used to wash his hands off just from a little bit of dough, where we can assume that he didn't really need an Atilas Yadayim. There are some poskim, however, who are machmir in this shayla and say that once he used it to wash his hands off, they were not completely clean, and that should be considered water for melacha. That is, the Shita of Taz and many achronim go with that chumra. This is Vayatir Mayim Shalifnei Hanapach, the water that is in front of a blacksmith. Afal Pishu Nishtana Mareim Psulim, even though they don't change their appearance, they're still possible. Mibnei Shabi Yadua Shanasav Melacha. We know the reason blacksmith has water there is to work with it. Tahenusha kiba b'hem abarza, when his iron gets too hot, he sticks it in this water. Vishalifne hasapar, if there's water that's in front of a barber, nishtana marehem sulam b'mav kshem, that will depend if they changed their collar, because we don't know for certain that he did, in fact, wash anything off in these kalim. I'm sure Shosumim Matanagom, if there's water that chickens drink from Ocean Laka, Kameyama Kalav, the Perishtia Sakilv Nikrilakika, the drinking of a dog or a chicken, Yishmisha Postal, some say that this is possible. The Aina Devar of Nirin, where even though there is such a Shita, it does not seem to be that the Halacha should follow this. I mean, even though we do find this Sugya in Masechta Parah about water that was being drawn to use for the water of the Paraduma, it doesn't really seem to be able to bring this from over there to over here. Whatever animal might drink from it should be kosher. There are some other opinions about it. There's some who would be machmir from a dog, if you have from mias or a pig, the mias, the Mishnah Berurah also talks over here about Mayim Megulan, if we have to be careful for that, the fact that the water was left uncovered, even though we're often no way to be making to drink that, does that apply here? Discussion in the post. The Mishnah Berurah also points out over here, so I had a note that if the waters would get mixed together, it would go after the roiv, as long as it still looks like kosher water. Malacha is only a problem of water that was mayim shuvim, ben shem mikli, ben shem makarka, whether in the vessel or in the ground, of aloba me mikva o mayim ba'odam mechubarim. It is not a problem to do tevilas yadayim in the mikva or the mayim, from with this kind of water, they did malach in it. Chame ha'ur, water that has been heated by fire. You can use it to wash your hands. And this is Pirsha Kolsha, Kreser Shiltinuk Nichve Emenu. This is the Shiro, if something that's hot is something that would burn a child, the newborn, maybe if they poured it on him. So that is my Yad Sanadas. It would be very hot. Afavichin, you can use it for Nitzil Sinai. Chame Tiveria, which is naturally hot water, Yachol Lahatmel Bemesidem, you can use it for Tivilas Yadayim. Avalitol Mehem Bekilo, you cannot pour it from in a vessel. And the reason is that this water is not drinkable. So therefore, that's why it's possible. V'imhimshech osan ba'aretz, derechritz chosom ha'komam, if you made some sort of irrigation system to have them flow out of the Chamei Tiveria to a new place, v'fsikan me'amayin ha'noveh, now it's separate from that original source. V'mirish b'mshir mikveh, if there is enough for a shir of a mikveh, matbilan b'hamayadam, you can use it for tevilas yadayim. But otherwise you cannot, because this water is not acceptable otherwise. However, if this chritz, this indentation that you have in the ground, is flowing and connecting the water from the hot from the hot spring to this new point, what about if that place is still connected? We cannot use it. But according to the Rav Rabbeinu Yonah, you could use it. And the shaila is that now that it's connected, does that make it also, because it might be a gzera that you would come to use this in a kli, which we said you cannot do, or do we not make the gzera once it's not connected? Tam epistle chamei tiveria natilas. The Chamei tells us what's the reason that this is possible. The water is bitter. And a dog cannot drink it. The nafkamina is that if we would ever find somewhere a hot springs where the water is flowing that is potable, the dog would drink it. You could use it for netilas yadayim. If there is also salty water or rotten water or bitter water, it's not even acceptable for a dog to drink. You cannot use it for netilas yadayim, even though it is kosher water for tevila in a mikvah, and also for tevilas yadayim it would be kosher. If they are considered cloudy from mud that's in there, if however a dog would still be able to drink from it, then you could use it for netilas yadayim or for a mikvah. If a dog cannot drink it, then Sulam Mishneim, they're possible both for the Tilas Yadayim and for a mikveh, because they're just considered mud, it's not considered water. You can use anything that originated from water. You can use the Yavchushim, which is Perish Tolem, it's a type of bugs, red bugs that came out of the water, and that's something that's a Birya Samayim, Oshuman Dog, or the fish, fish fat. Venera Davkim Riskon. You have to, however, make this liquidy or crush it to go out of Mishal B'chul, should be no better than the case of snow, which we'll see later in Sif Yud Beis. Ma'am Shish Go Safik Ibn Asav Malach Alav, if you have a Safik whether Malach had been done with this water or not, O Shiyesh Go Safik Ibn Yeshu Bahem Kashir Imlav, or is a Safik if it has a right shear? Oh, Imhem Timei Motorm, or the Safik if the water is Tomei or Tor, whether possum or not. O Safik im Natal Yadav im Eilav, or he has just as Safik if he was Yotze or not, Tahor, his hands are considered Tahor, and he does not need an Tilas Yadayim. V'chol Safik Tarab Yadayim Tor, and any Safik relating to Taras Yadayim, all these halachas we go Lekula, because this is the mitzvah to Rabbana. V'yesh Misha Omer, however, there's an opinion that says like this, She'an kol zos im yesh l'mayim achin mitol Yadav Yotze asam in a Safik. If you have more water, you should wash your hands again and be Yotze from the Safik. And then, it would be a good thing to do. And with all of these things, all these the sfeikis, since presuming that it's an easy thing to do, obviously b'shasat chaki could be some mechalakum. But if he's able to get water, just wash his hands again. Hagam yishalol nato yodav v'nagav b'mayim, someone did not wash his hands, but he touched water. Lo osan mayim l'netilo. So that water does not become possible for netilas yadayim because it was touched by someone who has not yet washed his hands. Doesn't make them tamei. But you cannot reuse the water that the other one used. would cause, besides the fact that it's tameh, that's considered to have been mayim that they did a malacha. Hashalag v'habarad v'hakfer v'aglid. So if there's the snow, hail, kfer glid is ice, perishamayim anikvim made of hakfer, the ice or frost. V'hamelach, or salt, this is sea salt. We're talking about, this would apply only in the case of tevilas sinaim. So before that, salty water does not cannot be used for tevilas sinaim. Imiriska and achinasimaim, if you crush these things, I mean the snow or the ice, you crushed it into water. Notes going to mayhem, you can use it for tevilas sinaim, vitovan bem or tevilas sinaim, imyish bem kashir. And biyudesim rish alf sifnam, a lot of halachas about using snow or ice to create a mikvah. And if there are cases that you could use the snow as it is without crushing it, b'shas adchak, as a mikvah, yesh or and therefore for tevilas yinayim as well. Yesh misha omer she'in and the tevilas mayim rishonim al b'mayim b'lavad. However, there is some who say that you must use water. V'yesh omerim she'yayin kashin and tevilas yinayim, and some say that you could use wine. Bein nasan l'socha mayim, bein lo nasan l'socha mayim, and this machokas would not make a difference whether or not. Whether or not you added water to it. However, all agree that nechatchila you cannot use wine to wash your hands. Because this would look like you're treating lightly something that's chashuv shenishtana le'ili. The wine has been changed to be something that is a special thing. Perish l'shevach hachikavir bracha atzmo. It has its own unique bracha, and therefore it's more special than any other liquid. V'yesh omnim davga yayin lavan. Some say that there's always talk about white wine, avon adam lo, but that red wine you can never use because it doesn't look at all like wine. V'yesh mishramang is another opinion that says, shekome peris riyam lin tilis nam shas. The fact that it is not just about wine, all may peiros are acceptable b'shas adchak. The Mishnah Berurah points out that the first 2 days do not make a chiluk between wine and may peiros. The first day would say only water. The second day would say may peiros and even wine, except wine lechatchila you shouldn't use. And this is really a third day saying you could use may peiros, but you can never use wine. V'chol shekin demotar litol yadayim b'shas adchak b'shecher b'medvashim b'shol and irkamayim. Certainly, you could use beer or you could use mead. Or something else that's a drink that really is mostly water, even though something has been edited, and you can do that b'shas hadchak. And the poskim talk about this, whether or not we can be somich on this lemaisa. The Mishnah Berurah comes out that lemaisa b'shas hadchak, one could use other mei peiros, but not to use wine, if possible. Because that we see many Rishonim are saying not to use at all. Sarech sheyehe b'mayim revius. You have to have a revius of water. This is a revius of water to wash one person's hand. What if two people want to wash their hands at once? Ha'achin in sarech. The second one does not need a revius. Even if they're washing one after the other, as long as the flow doesn't stop. Ketzad. What does this mean? You have a revius of water in your kli. And one person stretches out his hands, and someone else pours on his hands. And so the second person came and stuck his hands out right below the first person's hands. And the flow of water washes both of their hands. Both of their hands are tahor. Even though it was just exactly one revius, and therefore the second one certainly did not get a full revius of water on his hands, you're still tahor. That comes from the leftovers of a procedure that was tahor. Some say this is permitted even one after the other. First person poured out from the revius, and there was still something left in the barrel. You can continue to pour. Since it came from Shiurei Tahara, they understand that's Bechal what Shiurei Tahara is. One could be so mech mishnah versus on this second shita. The same thing to do a half a log, which is a two revi'asin for three people arba'a, or for even four people min log. If you have four revi'asin, which is a whole log, we can do for however many people you need. As long as it's enough to pour three times on each person's hand. Let's say really you only need two times, but we try to do a third time. You have four or five people put their hands right next to each other, or right on top of each other, and wash their hands at once. But their hands have to be loose, so the water will wash both of them. The revius of water that you're pouring has to be in one place. Because if you took a smaller shear, you took a shminas halug, v'chazar v'nato mishminas halug, another shminas halug, yod of tamez kasher, it doesn't help, and the hands are still tame. Revius sh'amru, bein yod of shangalom, bein yod of shangkatan. This shear revius does not matter how big or small a person's hands are. Not shne b'nei adam, zeh yod of achas, v'zeh yod of achas. Two people washed one hand each. And the second washed his second hand. That's considered like three people. You would need to have had a half a log, a double revius, to make this tar. Even though if they had washed their hands mamish at the same time, one revius would have been sufficient. Otherwise, in yod hashni, the second hand will not be tar. You cannot use less than a half a log, which is twice the revius, so it's 6 to 10 ounces. You cannot use less than that for any more than two people washing together.